Well, we're back at it. Now I got to make this other piece, the other side. I'm still debating on what to do about these pieces. I think I might make them out of some hard 3/32 instead of 8. That'd be a 32nd less. Of course, it doesn't much matter. We'll just. The only thing I'm gonna have to hold it together and measure what the width is here, because it can be no more than 2 3/4. So let's make another fuselage side and see what happens. Found some 16th ply, which I knew I had. Okay. So we got to get our pieces here that we wish to use. So this long enough. This is what I use for the front. And I gotta use the lightest one of these two for the back. Twenty-six before it's crappy looking. Not much care for the grain in that. This is what I used for the rear, I think. I used this for the rear. We don't have enough here for that. Okay, I didn't keep them separated. Oh well. This is going to be the back half. 23, 26. This is the front. Boy, I wish I could get good wood in the sizes that I want. So, wait a minute. We can save some wood if I use this for the front. This for the front and that for the back. That's how we'll do it. Okay. Okay, so that's inside. We're going to be cutting so I need to make a datum cut. Thank you. Pretty good, pretty good. Yep, that's what we're gonna do. That'll save two pieces of wood. That's good. I'd like to find a better pen. How we doing on a Sunday? Everybody doing okay? Sunday! What am I doing? Building airplanes. What do I always do? Sand. Sandu the Bandu. As you can see, the second side goes pretty quick because I've already laid out the first side, did all the thinking. The thinking took the time. That's how I do it. My brain is just about shot. I got about halfway to the store and realized that I forgot my cell phone. Now my cell phone has the discount card in it and my insurance. So I turned around and come back. I said, we'll leave the market for another day. I just went to a little convenience store and got me 3 TV dinners. So I got 3 days to get my shit together. I'm really losing it. I can't find things here or leave things. It's all a stress. Maybe I need to quit watching the news. One of these damn pens has got to work. Man, I got a big wiring job I gotta do tomorrow. I dread thinking about going to work. Damn trucks, I can't get the damn headlights out. Shit. Yeah, I know, I did it different this time, but that's okay. Different is good. Different is good because you'll see how I do it. Really get a good angle on the darn thing. There we go. Alright, how I'm going to do this, to make them exact, is to put this on the bench. I'm going to clamp it. Get a clamp. If you don't have any of these Harbor Freight clamps, you better get some. They're really handy. Let's do it this way. No, I guess it don't matter. It don't. Two likes, eight watchers. For you guys who are watching this after the live stream, if this video helped you, leave me a super thanks. That's that little heart icon down there. Or if you're watching it during the live stream here, you can always send a super chat. I can't get a clamp on the back. Thank you. Need to get some new blood in here. This is the inside. A little bit of a, it's not quite a perfect gap, so we got to fill it with some CA. Not going to see it. This is on the inside, but I don't want it to break while I'm handling it. We'll be fine. It'll be fine. Okay, now the experiment. So we got board out around like that. I'm going to tack it together with a drop of CA just to hold it. To cut it apart. All these things need to be trued up anyway. Okay, now for the paste of resistance. I'm sure you guys have heard that, pièce de résistance, it's paste of resistance. Please be right. If it's not right, I'm going to have to think again. I think I better make a temp bulkhead for there. So, just a temp. We'll make this out of light fly. When I can get over to John's. Which will be about 2 weeks, because next weekend we'll be in Cleveland. Okay. Close enough. Put a tack right there. Break on me. Okie dokie. Keep your fingers crossed. Okay. So this comes back to here. measurement here. 2 3/4. We're in there no problem. Man, I'm thinking ahead. Good shape. Good shape. Let me measure that again. We got 1/8 inch. All right, I can go ahead and use those 1/8 inch doublers. So we'll get working on that. We'll get laying those out. I think I'm going to go ahead and just glue the doublers onto these joints so they don't break. Everything appears to be copacetic. Let's see what this business weighs. Probably heavy. I'll take that clamp off though. That clamp is very heavy. It's 3 3/4 ounces, so that might make 7. If I make 7, I'm in there. Of course, we got some of that to take off. So while I'm doing this, while this is drying, I can cut the fuselage pocket to make sure that's going to work. So might as well get that measurement now before I lay these up. What are you doing? There you are. Most guys don't go through this business. They don't set their tank back into the wing. We are at 2 490,000ths. So we'll just say check it again. We'll just say 2 400,000ths. So it's 1 and 200. 2 and 400 thousandths. That's 1 and 200. Now back. It's 202 inch, 130 thousandths. So we'll say 2 150 setback. Setback. Wide. That tack already broke loose. Stupid thing. Okay, well, that doesn't matter. It don't matter. I'm going to go about this one a little bit different too on cowl fitment. Because this is a piped airplane, before I ever strike a block on this thing, I'm going to line the cowl. I always have fitment problems where I got a fiddle at the end, so I'm going to do it different this year. I mean, I get it done, but it's just a big pain in the butt. And I know that's how I should be doing it. Just because I know doesn't mean I'll do it. Especially when I'm taping like this, I get ahead of myself. Okay, that one fits no problem. One needs a little trimming. But I better put them lines on it before I do anything else. That's a good thing to do too, is mark those things so you don't put the glue on the wrong side, because I have done it. So we need to clean up this mess a little bit so I get some working room. Took an hour on one side and 40 minutes on the other side to get it set up and ready to go. I wonder if this long tank would fit. I don't think so. beer. God, I'm pissed off. This long tank may fit even. I mean, I'm not going to use this. It's too heavy. But. But it's nice to have options, you know. 8 ounce clunk, thick fiberglass tank, carbon tank. That. Now remember, I normally don't build from any set of plans. I don't normally do a set of drawings. I only did the drawings because of this setback in the tank. Set back to shorten the nose. Normally what you can do is build your motor crutch, set your engine on, set your motor crutch on the fuselage side, and wherever the bulkhead ends up is how long the nose is going to be. Well, if you're building specifics, you you have to think ahead. And that's why the drawing. Like I say, I don't work with drawings normally. However, I do like the shape of the rudder better on this one than the other one. So I think it's going to be a nicer looking, more streamlined looking airplane than the other one. And the other one's got classic lines. But I kind of stole the look from Billy's Junar. Okay, so we can get these drawings out of the way. I need them because I got my numbers on there, but I don't need to use them again. Rubber band handy? Probably not. Well, Probably not, so we get a piece of tape. Shit. Can't win. Oh, there they are. There it is. The chat working? Are you guys not? Are you guys sleeping or what today? Duration is 7 minutes. You guys get tired of me in 7 minutes. You know what? I don't have any 30-minute epoxy. Crap. All I got's 5 minutes. Well, I won't be gluing those together tonight. So, let's work on cutting the wing up. Shit, I forgot about that. No epoxy. Stop by Lowe's tomorrow and get some 30-minute epoxy. I rolled them plans up and forgot. It's 1 and 20 and 2 and what? One and 200. I've been working on this airplane ever since after the Nats. this. I need this. One and 200. Okay, 1, 2, and 150. 2 and 150. Oh yeah, we got plenty of room. 1 and 200. Hey Gary. Well, this video was entailing how to get this. So, before I cut that, we got to make sure that we're not going to be into the bell crank. It doesn't look like it. Now, the bell crank is way back here. So we have about 3/8 of an inch play to mess with. So I need this. We need a new blade. Can't use an old shitty blade for this. we'll need this. You can't believe how many times I've been told, you can't do that! Well, every airplane I got is done this way. We have to move this rib. That's one of the reasons why I didn't glue it in. Oh yeah, we're in fine shape. Be in fine shape. Take this ring off so I don't dent the wood. Well, where's my mother's saw again? I could use that saw. Exacto used to make a saw blade. I used to have one. The only problem was they were kind of thick. Five-eighths times 2. We'll do these first. 9 5/8. There's a half. There's 5/8. 9 5/8. One and 200 thousandths. One and 200. You know, the nice thing about this, I can check it before I glue it together. Make sure it's going to be a perfect fit. Why didn't that look right? What's the story here? It's right, though. A little big so I can sand it. If I do this wrong, the model's over. I don't think I could repair it. I guess that's right. Better check that measurement again. I think it may need to go over this way just a smidge. One and 200. One and 200. See, it's just a little off. So. I'll use my eyeball. Better. Now I gotta get that out of there. Where's my mother's saw? How about my back saw, maybe? Oopsie. It's all so sharp. It would have been better to find the other saw, but I ain't gonna spend all day looking for it. Now, if you do this, if you ever do, this has to have a rib put back in here right at the edge. Otherwise, there's no strength there. Okay, so now I want to see if this all is going to work. So I need my crutch, which is here. And the two bulkheads, the two doublers. One, two. Buckle my shoe. Probably should glue that other piece back in there. Yeah, let's glue that other piece back in there. That way I know exactly what's going on. I think it's right. I thought about it and double checked it and stuff. Yeah, didn't go off too crazy. Look at that. Just like it was meant for it. So, this is the dimension I needed right there. So that this would slide in. The fuselage sides catch this on the outside. And there, I mean, that is, you couldn't ask for a better fit. Perfecto. In order for this to slide back, I need to grind out these motor mounts. So we're not going to force it back in there. Oh, I guess I could put it up like this. That's it. Let me turn the other camera and get a good shot of it. You see the fit here? And that other piece of wood sits on the outside, so you know, that seems 100% gone. Them on the wrong side. Oh well. No worries. They're the same. So now I need to build this box. I think we're going to leave that for another time. Hour and 12 minutes. No action. So this goes back to there. So this is ground out. The wing is glued to the top of the motor mounts. The bulkhead is glued to the wing. I mean, it ain't coming apart. However, like I said, you got to make sure that you put a rib in here. Has to have a rib in there.
look and see what's going on in there. Yeah, we got lots of clearance. Clearance, clearance! So we'll glue these together. Except I don't think that much matters either. Grind that out with the ball, or I could just sand it out with my fingers. I need to grind them back. So I first piece to put in is an 1/8 inch piece going this way from rib to rib, so it'll extend from here to here up and down this way, and then put the ribs in this way, flush with this, and then glue it together, and it's boxed in. And when you cover these, you take your tissue and you go around the corner, and you know, the dope is a glue. So this, the dope and the tissue are all gluing this together to become structural. That makes sense. I don't think I explained tank boxes in my past videos as in depth as this. But I think that's going to do it for this evening. I'm kind of burnt out. I've still got a little work to do this wing. I need to cut these shear webs off, and because I told you I moved my hinges over, I need to put in another hinge block where they belong, and then put the shear webs back in, fix the tank, then the wing is 100% done. So we'll probably be up to 13 ounces by then, but there's not much I can do. I mean, it is what it is. Spot right there I gotta fix. Alright guys, thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow night. Possibly. Tomorrow night's Charles's night again. So fair winds, tight lines. We'll see ya.